The real joy that we can experience in meditation comes when we feel free from the sense of self. When our attention becomes free from being identified with our thinking and also liberated from the sense of being a self, then automatically we experience consciousness as divine happiness. When we go beyond ourselves, there is only happiness, infinite happiness, that is consciousness. Now let's look at this sense of self. Part of it, a big part of it, is our identification with our thinking. Our attention grabs hold of our thoughts and says, this is me. And this forms the ego, the sense of me that is separate from everything else. It is a mental experience beyond the sense of the physical body. It is a mental experience that is ego. We believe we are our names, our opinions, our judgments, our past. I'm not saying we aren't these things, but it contracts our attention into ego perception. So everything we perceive is perceived through the ego, is perceived through the intellect. We see a bird and our attention sees the bird, and that perception goes through our thoughts. What kind of bird it is, our judgments of the bird according to our past experience. And thus there's always the experience of myself and the bird, which there's nothing wrong with that. But in meditation, when we can turn our attention, either by relaxing our attention out of being involved with thinking and then witnessing our thoughts, or by turning our attention to a mantra, so we have one pointed focus on a mantra, both ways take us out of ego perception and into an experience of awareness, of peace, of bliss. There are other practices, but this is what comes to mind at the moment. Now, if you notice within yourself, if you are resting in the awareness that is free of thought, whether there is no thinking or you are a witness to your thinking to a certain degree, you still feel a sense of separation. You still feel a sense of self. Now it may be peaceful and blissful to a certain degree because you've become free of thought identification, but it is still a feeling of separation, that feeling of I am, that feeling of being that is not of thinking but is beyond thinking. It's still a feeling of separation. Now the essence of that being, of that consciousness, is transcendental bliss. But at that level of consciousness, we still feel a sense of self. And so, to get to the feeling where we go beyond the self, where there is just pure consciousness, and pure consciousness at that is infinite happiness, infinite joy, infinite bliss, infinite goodness. There is a lot of spiritual work that we have to do day in and day out. Meditation is one part of it. We may have to do other practices as well, like breathing techniques, chanting, devotional practices, taking care of our body with diet and exercise. Even yoga poses you might find helpful. But it is a day in, day out process of awareness, of letting go of thought identification, focusing your attention one-pointed on whatever you're doing, so you're not carrying your thoughts around with you. You're not carrying what happened 10 minutes ago, a year ago, 10 years ago around with you. You have those memories, but you don't hold on to them. You don't carry them around. You'll start to feel your attention becoming free from them. You'll start to feel a sense of goodness, of joy that is unconditional. And that feeling of joy is a feeling you are becoming liberated from yourself. You're no longer bound by this sense of self. You've become humbled into your true nature. And it is humbling. It is not an attainment. If I go into this sense of transcendence, of being free of the self, it is a humbling, it is a bowing down, it is a giving myself completely, offering myself completely. There's no sense of attainment in it. It's the opposite. It's a complete bowing down, giving yourself to this moment. And this happens over time. It is not that you can just stop your thinking and experience what I'm talking about. You stop your thinking, you will experience consciousness that is free from thought. But that consciousness is still a feeling of separateness. It's actually a different part of your brain gets activated. The ego perception is a certain part of your brain that is working and that perceives reality. But when you learn to relax that part of your brain so it slows down, so it stops working so much, new part of your brain, you can actually feel it being activated. New part of your brain starts to function and you experience this moment directly without it going into the ego perception. And at this level, there is just delight. There is just goodness. There is just love. The sense of going beyond the self is not scary, does not feel like death. When you're in the ego and you're seeing, you're starting to look beyond ego perception. It seems frightening because you're in ego perception. Because you don't know what's there. Because you can't know what's there. When you go beyond the sense of self, it is not that you are dead. It is that you experience the true nature of everything, which is your true nature, which is eternal delight. So things like being humble, being respectful of others, letting go of your arrogance, letting go of your hatred, letting go of your judgments, letting go of making your opinions important, your knowledge important, what you've attained important. It's an ongoing process in this way. So the direction to go in meditation is allowing yourself to be, accepting yourself as you are, but letting it go. Letting go of holding on to this sense of self, both with thought identification and trying to control this moment, do this moment, attain something. You let that go too. And it's a journey. Day-to-day learning experience of how to let go of this sense of self, how to let go of self-importance, how to let go of separation, which is not an intellectual learning. You feel into it and you feel the peace and the goodness that comes when you let go of yourself. Please feel free to subscribe if you got something good out of this video, which I hope you did. Much love to you.